Now to a story we broke on WIFF4.com earlier today. A big mistake by a SLED agent cost an upstate county a major drug case.
News 4's Mandy Gaither has been working on this story all day, and she's live and local in the Anderson newsroom tonight. Mandy, how did this happen?
Well, Carol, SLED Chief Mark Keel told me there was a misrepresentation with regards to the identity of a person in the affidavit, and evidence wasn't handled properly. He says those mistakes were made by a SLED agent.
It was one of the most touted cases in the upstate last year, a major drug bust called Operation Reno 911, which was said to have broken up a drug organization which supplied the majority of powder and crack cocaine in Anderson County. 32 arrests, $500,000 in cash, and 4.5 kilos of cocaine all seized. But now the case against half of those suspects arrested has been dropped, all because of mistakes made by a SLED agent.
My officers, my narcotics officers in particular, put in many, many hours, surveillance hours, sitting up in the woods watching some of these locations and things like this, and it's very frustrating and disappointing to them.
Anderson County Sheriff John Skipper said there's plenty to show those arrested November 10th of last year are guilty, but that evidence against 16 of the suspects cannot be used in court. That, according to the state attorney general's office and SLED's chief, Mark Keel.
Mandy, I tell you, I'm very upset. I'm disappointed at the fact that it comes to this.
Keel, seen here at his nomination ceremony in June, told us by phone this happened before he took the job. The agent in question was fired in March because of the handling of this case.
This is our responsibility, SLED. We had an agent that failed to carry out his responsibilities.
As for the Anderson County investigators involved in the case, Keel says they did nothing wrong.
And get this, a lot of the stuff confiscated during this case will be returned to the suspects. That includes vehicles, cash, and guns. Of course, those who are convicted felons will not get their guns back. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.